Boy, Uncle Dave is sure gonna be surprised when he finds this new coral I bought him for his birthday in his aquarium.
Joseph, what are you doing in my fish tank?
Well, I was trying to surprise you for your birthday with these purple people eaters. Well,
that's mighty nice of you, Joseph, but did you treat that coral with CoralRx first?
No need to, Uncle Dave. This beast looks perfect.
No, Joseph, no!
So, what's there to do around this reef?
Well, we're into being healthy. We eat right, get plenty of light, and grow.
Well, that sounds pretty boring. You guys need to live on the edge of the reef. Any of you guys in the Nudibranchs?
No.
Well, how about flatworms or red bugs?
Never.
What about spiders?
Absolutely not. Stop pushing.
Come on, dudes. Let's rock this reef. One flatworm's not gonna hurt you. It'll be a blast.
Okay, just one flatworm, but then I gotta go. Wow, man. This feels kinda good. Oh man, I ain't feeling so good.
Hey guys, who let this coral into our aquarium without dipping him in CoralRx?
Look, Uncle Dave sees that we're sick and he's pulling out the CoralRx. Thank you, Uncle Dave. Thank you.
Yeah, but it never should have come to this. If only Joseph knew to first use CoralRx before ever putting a new piece of coral in our aquarium.
That's mighty nice of you, Joseph, but did you treat that coral with CoralRx first?
No need to, Uncle Dave. This beast looks perfect.
Joseph, stop.
Well, what for?
Listen, son, a beautiful coral can still carry critters that we don't want. Any coral, for that matter, can carry parasites you might not be able to recognize. It's much easier to be proactive in treating every coral we purchase with CoralRx before putting it in the aquarium versus pulling corals out of the aquarium after the fact. Let me show you how easy it is to dip this coral in CoralRx. We start by measuring the appropriate amount of CoralRx to be used with 1 gallon of salt water. Next, we take our coral and we gently shake it in the CoralRx solution for about 5 minutes. You will immediately see parasites begin to eject themselves off your coral. You can now see these unwelcome critters at the bottom of the bowl. Lastly, we rinse the coral with clean salt water and place it in the aquarium.
Wow, Uncle Dave, that was easy. I can't imagine why anyone wouldn't dip their coral in CoralRx before putting it in their aquarium.
I couldn't agree with you more, Joe. I've personally witnessed CoralRx remove Acropora-eating flatworms, red flatworms, Montipora-eating Nudibranchs, Zoanthid-eating Nudibranchs, Bristleworms, Zoanthid-eating Sundial snails, Zoanthid-eating spiders, and some hair algae. The best part, Joe? It is incredibly gentle and does no damage to the host coral. If we ever had an outbreak in the aquarium, repeated treatments are possible every 4 days to help break the life cycle of stubborn pests.
Thanks, Uncle Dave. You taught me a valuable lesson today.
You know what they say, Joseph? An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure.